glad to ever claim a workout with Megan, but it is Alesha Rose. She is a 5-star diamond, a 6-figure earner in beach climbing. She has made success club, you guys, 80 months. What? 80-ish. Period, a lot. That's a lot, you guys. Most people haven't even heard of beach climbing that long. So here she is, Alesha Rose.
Today is a lot of what went on in the video, so this is going to go perfect. So what I want to talk about first is a little bit about my story, because many of you don't know who I am, and it goes back to 9 years ago. So I've been a coach for 7 years, but it really starts at 9 years in that middle picture. I don't want to cry on this, because so 9 years ago, I'm in the Army Reserves. I actually have drill this weekend. Yay. And I've been in for 15 years now, and I was given a 4 days notice to deploy. So my son was 18 months, and my daughter was 3. Sorry. I cried every single time when I'm rehearsing this. I'm like, whew, good. So I remember, you know, you see all these stories of, you know, all these people coming home from war, and you see them, it's like the crying in those videos. That's me, like, every single time I think of this, because I missed a whole year of life. And especially at 18 months, that's a huge part. Like, my son, he was, I would have to help him with washing his face and, you know, getting dressed, and then by the time I came back, he's like, I'm washing my face on my own. I got this, Mom. You know, like, I don't need you. I don't even know who you are. So this whole reason of why I wanted to build an amazing business was so that I could work from home and I could be around those kids more often, so we could build those memories and just be around them more often. So I came back, and like most people, we have a lot of anxiety. You're at this high alert of stress for 24/7 for a full year. And so I came back, and I was just constantly drinking, and we didn't have Mexican food over there, so Taco Bell was. And I gained a lot of weight coming back and having to deal with being in the corporate world and just that constant stress all the time. I was just so ready for something different. And it got to the point where I was in that, you know, upper picture up there. And I just wasn't happy with where I was at in my life. I was not happy with what I saw in the mirror, that none of my clothes were fitting right. And I know women, you're like, you can relate to this, you just put everything on, you're like, oh, this is not fit, put something else on, this doesn't fit. So I knew I had to do something different. And I thought I knew the way, you know, being in the military, I thought I knew. And I really didn't. I still hate the crap. So I had saw Insanity, and I was like, that is my jam, I'm going to do that, it's so perfect. I woke up every day at 4 a.m. to do it, and I lost 5 pounds in that first 60 days. So everybody was seeing my results. They absolutely were like, oh, you look so great, I'm referring it to other people. But I still wasn't happy because it was only 5 pounds. I was so stuck on that scale. And then I found, Jessica found me on Facebook, and I didn't know her, and we actually happened to live in the same area, which was so crazy. So it really was really crazy. And I had no idea who she was beforehand. I thought she was just weird. But she was so confident about, you know, helping me and helping this business. She was actually a pretty new coach herself. So I knew that there was something in this business that I needed, but I still thought it was a scam. I had all those preconceived notions. I was like, I don't need Shakeology, I have Muscle Milk, why do I need that? I didn't understand the difference. So I was like, fine, you know what? I'm gonna commit to this because I know for myself I need something different. So I'm gonna have to do something different, and I know that in my gut, this feels right. Even though my husband was like, no. He's still like, oh, honey, like, come on now. He's like my biggest skeptic in the world, and it's so hard to convince family members. And here I am 7 years, and he still doesn't drink Shakeology, he hates it, but my kids love it, so that's all that matters. So I did my second round of Insanity, but this time I incorporated Shakeology. And this, guys, is the game changer, because I lost 20 pounds in that second round. And so going from just 5 pounds in that first round to only thing I'm changing is Shakeology in that second round, like, and then losing 20 pounds, that, it really is our secret to our success. And it really makes a huge difference of having dense nutrition and fueling your body correctly. So, you know, of course I'm like, oh, this is amazing, I absolutely love it. And, you know, my business just grew from there. So now I've been doing this for 7 years. 2 years into the business, I was laid off from my corporate job, and I was the crazy person. I was like, yes, thank God. Like, I am, hate this job, see you suckers. You know, I absolutely hated that job. And I was the weirdest person ever because you're like, are you sure? Are you okay? Like, you're getting laid off. I'm like, yeah, I'm fine. I've got my Beachbody thing. And I knew from that moment on that I was going to be able to see my kids get on and off the bus and be able to help them with their homework. And that was everything to me. So, anyway. So now we're going to go into the presentation. So I'm going to talk about creating daily success in your business. So how many of you have no idea what to post? You're like, you're thinking every single day. You're like, I have no idea. What am I going to talk about today? You know? Absolutely. I do it all the time. I'm like, I don't feel it. I don't know what I'm going to post about. Like, how can I encourage people? I just have no idea. So Melanie Beecher talks a lot about marketing plans. And even on the past National Wake Up Call this week, she talked about a marketing plan. And for me, that's so overwhelming. I have like a marketing plan. Like, that requires sitting down. That's going to take hours. I don't have that much time. You know, so I'm going to break it down for you of creating a plan, like for Clean Week and for 80-day obsession and everything else that's coming up. You can use this in order to help more people and create your marketing plan in your posts. So, all right, so I'm sure you've had prospects or even coaches, and they come to you and they're like, I really want to do this, but I have to have more time, or I need to have results in order to do whatever, and then I can be committed. You know, we always hear that, but it's the opposite. You have to be what you want to have first. You have to be the characteristics of those things that you want, so that way you can start doing the actions. Because if you want something bad enough and you want to have something, you have to grow and become that person first. Because otherwise you're never going to have what you want to have because you just stay in the same place, right? So doing is only as effective as who you are. This is really hard to change notes beforehand. So just look at your relationships around you, your job, your health, and your finances. All of those are a product of your thoughts. They're the product, even if you, like, I'm confident, I got this. You know, like, I don't have any issues. Like, that was totally me the whole first year. I was like, I have no issues whatsoever, I'm perfect. And we all know that we need personal development. We need to change our thought processes and how we react to certain situations. And this is what is really going to help you in becoming what you want to have, like an elite coach. You know, you think of elite, and you're like, oh, they're so strong, they're confident. You know, these are people, they just got it together, and they have it, and they answer anybody with no problem, which, you know, we also lack confidence sometimes and question what we're doing sometimes. But personal development is what really is going to start reprogramming your life around you. So you want to become a few things. So, you know, you want to make sure you want to know what your intention is every single day. So some questions you want to ask is, if I had, and then whatever that thing is, what would I be? What would I do? And how would I feel? Because when you get those things together, then you have a better understanding of your audience. So there's two characteristics of being, and it's being committed, because you have to be committed to the process. You have to be committed every single day. You have to be here, not just a year from now, but 5 years from now, and be committed to that no matter what's going on. Because even in Beachbody, you're going to have ups and downs. You're going to have coaches quit. You're going to have, you know, just things going on in your life that just seem impossible, like getting laid off, or when my father-in-law passed away, or, you know, we had to replace every window in our house. You know, there's things that just go on in your life that you feel that the world is coming down around you. But Beachbody is that thing that's going to help you overcome all of that. The community, the friendships, the financial part of it, that's what Beachbody is here for, is to help you overcome and grow to be able to go through all the situations. So the second thing is being responsible of the outcome. So when you are responsible for and taking ownership of whatever is going to happen, then you know that no matter what, if you fail or if you strive for whatever or you succeed, whatever happens towards the end in that outcome, it's because of your personal development that you change in yourself and your mindset. And it's also because that you are taking ownership of that, and hey, if you fail, you just get back up and you go again, because the failing is just your first attempt in learning. So you want to make sure that failing is a good thing. You want to fail because that's how you learn, that's how you grow. And I failed a million times, so it's okay. All right, so this is what we're going to talk about here, is being clear on your audience, choosing your theme, having some action steps, your pre-work ritual, and your daily action process. All right, so who is your audience? This is your first step. Like in Clean Week, you want to know who your audience is. Who is it that you're going to be talking to every single day? You just heard Megan Eggleston, who was talking about the people that she was attracting into her free groups. She had her 5-day free groups that she was doing, but it was all themed, and they were to a certain audience every single time. So that is your first step, is making sure that you're not appealing to the masses. Because as much as we want to appeal to everybody, and we do have a product for everyone, but we cannot help every single person, because they're just not going to be either attracted to you, they're not going to be jiving together with you, or they're just not ready in their journey. So you can't help every single person all the time, right? So you want to help a certain person every single time, and that is your audience. So, you know, what is it that your audience wants? What is it that they love? What are their hobbies? What do they like to do? You know, these are just a few examples up here of some of your audiences that I actually had asked in my team page of, you know, what is some audiences that you would think of? You know, so what is it that you love to do? And that's how I find my audiences, the things that I love to do, the places that I have been. I'm a huge Survivor fan, so like I created my own Survivor group just for that. And it's just nothing but talking about Survivor, which starts next week. So I'm so excited. And that's just part of this, is that you want to find a common bond with these people so you have something to talk about. And that is how you find your theme. So, a theme is a way to find that you are helping these people. So how are they getting help? So when you're doing your posts on your Facebook, I mean, do you look at your Facebook, does it look like that, where there's just random posts that are so out of whack that you're like, I don't know where that came from, but it's there. So some of your themes that you might have across your week is fears. Like mine was the fears this week, which you'll find out here in a second because I have examples. Maybe it's objections that you keep hearing over and over again. Maybe it's the no money objection. So now you're giving examples of people who have strived and who have succeeded in this business. Or maybe it's ways that people have overcome because of the financial aspect and have been able to do their, you know, challenge pack, or different ways that they could afford a challenge pack, or, you know, why it's such a great benefit, I guess. Can't think of the right word. But it's such, with challenge packs, you get such a great deal with those, so why not explain everything that they're getting when you're sending out those messages? You know, so go through and figure out what is it that you want to do each week as your theme. It could be your hobby, it could be meal planning, it could be confidence, it could be running kids around, and it's about, you know, you're doing posts every single week, or maybe a live video of, you know, your snacks that you take in your car, some daily sunshine, you know, or you're running around in time management, and how you use your time management with running around for kids' sports, or different, actually did this when my son did football, of all the different things that you should have as a football mom. And you have like a huge cart full of like fans, and you've got sweat towels, and you've got chairs, and you've got, you know, umbrellas, and you know, it's like 100 degrees out in the middle of summer. But there's so many things that I can show people, like this is everything that I bring and lug with me in my cart, to my bowling cart, you know, to football practice every single time. And that's just for me, you know. So, you know, you can relate to your audience by using your theme, and that's going to how they're going to be attracted to you. And that's how you're going to attract more people to you as well, is by posting out those vulnerabilities and to your audience.
So one of the things that I do is I go on to my On This Day, which is on Facebook, kind of like a time hop. And I search through and I was like, what is it, you know, that I've done in the past that, because I'm like, I have really great posts in the past, now I can't think of anything. So you can reuse those posts, but you can also come up with ideas, which is also how I came up with my ideas for this week. So I was like, oh, that's such a great idea. So then I put down all these ideas down, and then I'm thinking about like, okay, what are different things I can write about that theme? And then I'll just start writing up and putting down all on paper. And that's just how, it only takes like 5 minutes to do. Okay, so this is mine from this week. So mine was all about fears. And if you don't know, mine is in public speaking. And it's scary, but I'm also in the military. They teach you how to do classes, so I'm good. But I went through, and even, it wasn't just like, hey, I'm afraid of public speaking. It's, you know, I had this fear, but guess what? I'm going to overcome it, and I'm going to do it no matter what, because I want to get uncomfortable and get better at it. And because of the community of coaching, because of being a Beachbody coach, I've been able to have this support network of people who are positive and are going to support me no matter what. You know, that is what this is about. So you can use all your posts to be able to relate to Beachbody and to coaching or to your next challenge group. You know, I have a fear of what's in the water. And my husband, I gave an example of my husband. It was really scary because he made me drive the boat. It was our first time in the ocean, so we just bought a new boat. And it was something that we could do with the kids on the weekend and go fishing while I'm suntanning, because I don't fish. So I'm just like, sure, I'll go suntanning. And he's like, oh, look, you need to drive in case something happens to me. And I'm like, oh my gosh, there's waves, it's coming at me. And I'm like, this boat is gonna tip over. And I was like freaking out, it was so scary. But it's one of those things where I'm like, is there jaws in the water? I know there's sharks in the water here. You know, I'm originally from Alaska, so I know it's in the water up there. Down here, it's scary. So I was like, I'm just gonna drive it, and I'm like freaking out. But I overcame that fear, because if you don't overcome things, you're never going to grow. And the whole reason why I chose fears this week was because in my time hop, I had LASIK surgery 2 years ago. And it was one of the scariest things. When you have a laser shooting at your eye, like ripping it apart, I'm like, that's scary to me. Like, they can mess up and just totally ruin my vision. But I knew that even though it was scary, I pushed myself to be uncomfortable. I pushed myself to grow. And that's how you have to be within your Beachbody business. Is even though inviting somebody is scary, even though following up might be bugging them, that you feel like you're doing that, or you know, maybe you know, you're just not wanting to push yourself harder in your workouts, you have to overcome that wall and that struggle, and you are going to succeed in no matter what you do. And it's just gonna get easier every single time you do it. So now the more times I go out on the boat and drive, I'm not gonna be as scared. I'm still gonna be scared, just not as scared. And then afraid to fail, because I am a huge perfectionist and I am afraid to fail. But if you really realize that, you know, failing is just your first attempt at learning, and that you just keep going and striving for it and not giving up, and quitting is the only time that you are failing. So, but with all of these, when I'm posting it on my social media, I'm getting people like, oh my gosh, me too. You know, and they're commenting underneath it and like, oh my, I felt that same way too. Oh my gosh, I'm so afraid of water. You know, oh, you're so brave. And that's how you create connection with your audience, and you start to get more people connected onto your page. So once you're doing that, you need to make sure you're underneath there commenting on their stuff, so that way you're raising your affinity. A little Facebook tip there. So. Okay, so what action steps are you going to be taking throughout your week in order to make sure that you are making your marketing plan? So we're going to go over a few action steps. So for the first thing you have to do is a self-grounding ritual. And that is your personal development. And that is just making sure you're in the right mindset in order to grow and to make sure that you are, when you're inviting, that you're not coming from a place of negativity. Because it's very easy when coaches are canceling or your income is down or you didn't expect your volume to be as low as it was or whatever it is, or your husband's annoying you. You know, you don't want to message people when your husband's annoying you. So just a tip. So you have to do something that's going to be good for your for your mindset to get in that right place where you're excited. And it might be drinking Energize. It might be doing your workout. It might be doing personal development. For me, it's positive affirmations. There's a really awesome app. It's called Think Up. And what it does is you have a ton of different affirmations on there that you can choose from, like miracle morning affirmations, business ones, or you can put in your own. It records it in your voice, so you're saying your affirmation, which is really weird to hear your own voice, but it records it, and then it puts it to like a background of like spa music, so it's like very relaxing, and like very zen, and so you're having all these affirmations, and you just do that a couple times a day, and then you really start to, you know, breathe it in and think it, and now you're starting to change your mindset and change that those subconscious thoughts, because now you're fueling your mind positively. So these are some of the action steps. So you want to make sure that you're creating action steps that are actionable for you. This is just some examples, like content creation for social media. Spending some time doing Facebook posts or doing your Instagram posts. I use SendShare for mine, and I schedule everything out. So that way I can sit down, okay, this week I'm going to be talking about fears. Okay, I'm going to have, you know, the LASIK, the water, the, you know, everything else in there. I'm going to create my posts, schedule them out. It takes maybe an hour. So on one day, let's say on a Saturday, when, you know, nobody's on Facebook on Saturdays, I'm going to be creating all of my content for an hour. And then I'm going to be creating content for live streams. So what are my talking points that I'm going to be doing for my live streams that I have going on, and what platform am I going to be doing that live stream? And then I'm going to do my invite to follow-ups. How many hours are you going to be doing? Are you going to do 30 minutes a day? An hour a day? What days? No, honestly, every day. And then sending emails to my customers. I'm going to make sure that I'm doing that once a week so I'm not leaving anybody behind. Meal prepping, team calls, you know, and then measuring your metrics, which is figuring out 2 to 3 things that you need to measure, whether it's having people signing up for your clean week, or it's having somebody sign up for your email list, or whatever it is, something that you can measure in order to know that you are growing. Okay, so this is what I have as my daily action list of what I create. It's kind of like almost like a calendar, but I just put down everything that is that I have to do in that week. And then you can see at the bottom, I have the theme of the week. So I know even if I don't get my posts in that day, or I didn't schedule them all, I still know my theme, and you'll actually see this week's in here. But I take every single day and I write down what it is I have to do in that day. What is my intention for that week? Am I going to be inviting for a clean week? Or am I going to be inviting for 80-day obsession? Or am I going to be inviting to Shift Shop, you know? Or am I going to be posting transformation results? Or trying to get people into my next challenge group? Or am I inviting to the coach opportunity? We do sneak peeks. So, you know, am I going to be inviting to that? Those are things that you want to be thinking of, and what days that you're going to be doing certain things. Okay, so but you are creating this list. So it's all up to you on what you are doing every single day. It just kind of processes it a little bit easier so you don't feel like you have so much to do every single day, which I'll show you in a second. So this is mine for this week. So as you can see, you know, Monday, that's called a national wake-up call. We have a team call. And I do make sure I do my hour of invites and follow-ups and then working on this PowerPoint. You know, so that was super easy. You know, that's one day's worth of work, you know? So, but I'm not going to make sure that I'm going to, where I'm going, that makes sense. I am not going to put everything onto one day, you know, because when you create a to-do list, sometimes you get so overwhelmed by what you have to do that you're just like all over the place, right? You're just like, I don't get anything done because I'm trying to do every little bit of everything all over the place. So what I do is I break it up into little parts each day. And I even put my personal stuff in there because I know, like, on Tuesday, I had to go update my military ID card. And I know that's going to take most of the day, so I'm not going to do as much that day because I know I'm not going to get anything done. You just have to be realistic, right? So be realistic with what you have going on and working towards whatever it is that you have as your goal for the week. So whatever your intention is to complete that week, that's your marketing plan. And it's super easy. So let's say on Saturday, so tomorrow, I mean, I've got drill this weekend, but I actually work on my beach body business while I'm doing Army, so I have my Facebook ad, you know, content, and I'm cleaning out my emails, and I'm just doing things that, and I'm measuring my metrics. So I'm going back and making sure that I'm figuring out what things I need to work on, what needs to tweak, and grow from there in the next week. So hopefully, you know, creating this will help you. You can even use it into a Google Calendar and do it time-wise, so you can actually fill in the times of what you need to get done. And hopefully this helped you. So that's all I've got for today. I know we have our workout coming up as well, which I'm really excited about.